when you think of a government facility, you might imagine a bunch of bureaucrats spending too much taxpayer money on stuff that really doesn't matter. Boy, are you in for a surprise. This is the story of the Volpe Center. It's a government research facility in Cambridge, Massachusetts. First of all, they don't have a line item in the federal budget. They have to earn their funding by inventing solutions and solving problems in the real world. A few years ago, Admiral Ulrich, commander of United States Naval Forces Europe, said he wanted to know the location of every ship in the Mediterranean. The big defense contractors started adding years and zeros onto the problem. Then somebody called the Volpe Center, and two little-known engineers started a chain of events that would, in real and measurable ways, change the world.
2005, I was assigned in Naples, Italy, and I had two jobs. One was the commander of all U.S. naval forces in Europe and Africa, and then I had a second job as the commander of NATO forces, essentially south of the Alps.
This whole project started in the summer of 2005, when we went to our combat center and we only saw about 60 ships, 70 ships in our entire area of responsibility.
They were tracking 64 ships in the Mediterranean. So I asked them, well, how many ships are in the Mediterranean? They go, more than 64, we have no idea. And this had been bothering me, quite frankly, my entire career, my 35 years that I've been roaming the seas, is we never had a good idea where these ships were, where they came from, what they were carrying, where they were going. And in a post 9/11 world, it caused me concern that these ships were entering our harbors, like the harbor we have here at Boston, like this LNG carrier that's behind us. They come into our ports, they're very close to our downtowns, they go under our bridges, they go over our tunnels, and we really didn't have a good idea who they were and what they were carrying and what risk we were incurring. When we first started, I collected around me the best and the brightest I had on the staff, and I explained the problem. And then I explained to them that we were going to solve the problem and we were going to do it in short order.
My charge was to figure out how to do this at the lowest dollar value for the United States government.
And when they came back, I was somewhat disappointed because they start talking to me in years, and they start talking to me in tens of millions of dollars. And I did not find that very satisfying. Somebody said, well, if we could get the Volpe Center energized about this, we might have a chance. And then they called me back within a couple hours and said, we can do it for a couple $100,000, and is next Tuesday okay? And so I knew I liked these guys already.
What already existed was an international maritime set of regulations that said ships over 300 gross registered tons should broadcast an automatic identification signal, AIS.
And so what we did is we used that technology and putting sensors around the periphery of the Mediterranean to receive those signals, and putting those signals on as many ships as we could that would then send that information to the Volpe Center, we could form a picture.
So immediately we had a client display that shows geographically on a navigational chart all the positions of the ships that are being tracked.
The concept that we came up with, if you contribute AIS from your shoreline, you would receive the entire network's AIS in return.
The idea was to put together a voluntary network that cost virtually nothing, no barrier to entry for any country, everybody was treated as an equal, where if you gave what picture you saw locally, you got everything that everybody saw.
Before MSSIS came along, the Mediterranean was a large area of sea in which we had limited visibility of what was going on. And that visibility was dependent on whatever assets we had, military, to get on site to look at the areas we were interested in.
At this point in time, we had the technology, the transponders, the receivers. We had the Volpe Center, so we had a network that could receive all this information.
The way that Admiral Ulrich was able to entice all the other countries to join in so rapidly was really just eliminating the barriers to entry.
Indeed. The smallest nation with a limited resources can now see what all the other nations in the Mediterranean are seeing through MSSIS.
What this network has provided us is a way to collaborate on an even playing field with 54 nations.
We now have a much, much wider picture of the commercial shipping situation in the Mediterranean on a day-to-day basis. It's a massive step change from almost zero.
Software is now being used by thousands around the world.
It's more than just a tool now for maritime domain awareness and increasing maritime safety and security, but it has also now become a diplomatic tool. It's become a means to connect other nations with others that have similar goals, and that being maritime security and safety.